So one of the other materials that we've worked in the studio for making the models is an MDF board. MDF basically means medium density fiber board. It is an engineered wood product that is made from hardwood and softwood residues, which is made into fiber mixed with resin binder, and then it's made into sheets by applying a large amount of pressure. So this, the main difference between natural wood and the MDF is that natural wood comes from the trunk of a tree, and then MDF comes from any of the agricultural wooden residues or products that comes from the natural wood. So another difference between both of them is that natural wood has a grain and a color to it, and then MDF has only has the acquired color to it. And then since it is a byproduct, or it's made from the residue, it's much cheaper than natural wood. And then it's a material that has softness to it, so it's very easy to work with. It can create edges, smooth surfaces, and it does not have any splinters or voids to it like natural wood has. So it's relatively safer to work with. One of the major disadvantages with MDF is that if it is not treated properly, it is not water resistant. So it will bulk up and then it will shed layers, which is a problem. And then another issue is that when you're working, and this is a wood material, and it's not, since it's not a comparative lower thickness, you have to work with it on tools. Working with a saw or like a grinder, it releases particles, and these can be VOCs. VOC is volatile organic compound, which are harmful for your lungs. So you have to have safety equipment when you're working on this model.
So MDF comes in all sorts of sizes, from ranging from 2 mm thickness to 4 inches, 100 mm thickness I've seen, and the thinner MDF sheets are very good for laser cutting. MDF can be laser cut up to thicknesses of 5 mm or 6 mm in a normal laser engraving machine. Working with MDF thicker than that, it generally requires power tools or CNC machines. So while working with MDF, the major thing you need to know is not to use a lot of Fevicol while sticking the material, because Fevicol is a water-based adhesive. It is a water-based adhesive, and as we know that MDF, when comes in contact with water or moisture, it releases its layers. It falls apart. That happened with one of the models that was here. As if you look closely here, due to the use of a lot of Fevicol, it has split into layers, and we had to use a different technique to keep it together, that was stapling the things together. Here also we can see it has cracked onto here, and due to which this does not hold on. Working with MDF, you need to also pay attention to things like, because it is a very soft material, what you need to pay attention is to not use it like too hard on the sander. The sander will eat away its particles very easily. So you need to be careful, and you need to take a tolerance while working with it. And it is, personally I feel it is better to finish off MDF with hand. MDF, when you want to use it for something which will be used with moisture, so there are types of MDF which come with plastic integrated into it. There are some types of MDF which have a epoxy resin and hardener mixed with it, so they make it a little waterproof. Also the thing is, we can use a PU coat on this, and then after applying a PU coat on this, if we use melamine, it gives it a very wood kind of a finish. If we use a cloth to apply melamine to PU coated, something like the 2K PU we get it in both glossy as well as matte finishes. If we use the matte finish and then we use a melamine coat, it looks like actual wood. So yeah, this is one of the things.